knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
In the previous tutorial, we began looking at the various types of innate immune cells. With macrophages covered, let's move on to dendritic cells, abbreviated as DCs. Dendritic cells are capable of capturing and presenting antigens to the T cells of the adaptive immune system. The downstream effect of such antigenic presentation to T cells can lead to two outcomes: potent activation, known as immunogenicity, or inhibition, known as tolerance of effector immune functions. Activation of the adaptive innate immunity includes induction of CD4 plus T and CD8 plus T lymphocyte activation, as well as B lymphocyte maturation. In contrast, inhibition of adaptive immunity results in peripheral immune tolerance and maintenance of immune homeostasis. Immature DCs are continuously produced from the CD34 plus hematopoietic stem cells within the bone marrow and are found within lymphoid organs, epithelia, connective tissue, and the lymph. Multiple DC subsets have been identified in both mice and humans, and the current classification is quite nebulous, while also rapidly evolving. However, a combination of ontogeny studies and gene expression profiling have provided some insight into the variation within this cell type. The DC family consists of the following categories: conventional or classical DCs, or CDCs, plasmacytoid cells, or PCs, Langerhans cells, or LCs, and monocyte-derived cells, or MCs. CDCs, also called classical dendritic cells, or myeloid dendritic cells, are characterized by the expression of high levels of CD11C and display a characteristic morphology of long dendrite extensions. There are two primary CDC subpopulations in mice, CD11B- and CD11B+. In humans, CDCs express not only CD11B and CD11C, but various other differentiating markers such as CD1A and CD14, to name a couple. Murine PDCs, or those found in mice and related rodents, express low amounts of CD11C and express other markers such as SIGLEC-H and LY6C. Human PDCs express CD4, CD123, HLA-DR, and blood-derived cell antigen 2, or BDCA2, as well as toll-like receptors TLR7 and 9, but do not express the CDC marker CD11C. Langerhans cells are a special member of the DC family that are usually situated in the oral mucosal epithelium and the skin epidermis. These can be distinguished by expression of Langerin, or CD207. Langerhans cells play an important role in immune surveillance by promoting immunity or tolerance through activation of antigen-specific T cells. Immature DCs express various pattern recognition receptors that constantly sense the surrounding environment for pathogens, such as viruses and bacteria. Activation and maturation of DCs is initiated after capturing appropriate antigens or inflammatory cytokines. Mature DCs then perform their primary task of antigen presentation at their cell surface using MHC molecules. This step is crucial in mounting the acquired or adaptive immune response by interacting with lymphocytes, and this interaction occurs in the lymph nodes. CDCs present antigens and produce the stimulatory mediators TNF, nitric oxide, and IL-12. They also recognize both bacterial and viral antigens. Immature CDCs patrol various tissues to sample foreign antigens. During maturation, CDCs migrate over to draining lymph nodes in order to present pathogen-derived peptides to T cells. PDCs can also act as antigen-presenting cells, but they are much less efficient than CDCs. PDCs predominantly recognize viral antigens, specializing in the production and secretion of type 1 interferons IL-12, IL-6, TNF-alpha, and pro-inflammatory chemokines. PDCs enter the lymph nodes directly via the bloodstream. alterations in DC function originating from genetic and environmental factors may lead to the development of autoimmune diseases. In autoimmunity, DCs act as a double-edged sword. On one hand, they mount adaptive self-reactive responses, but on the other hand, they promote and maintain immune tolerance. Disruption of the tolerance network that relies on multiple DC subsets can promote autoreactive T-cell responses and pathology. Therefore, therapies targeting DCs are being extensively studied as they may provide effective treatment for autoimmune diseases, such as rheumatoid arthritis and multiple sclerosis. Furthermore, several DC subsets have been reported to activate all types of effector T cells and regulate immune responses, which are involved in patterns of cardiovascular diseases. Designing DC-targeted vaccines has been a heavily studied approach in the field of vaccine development in recent years. This is because of the critical role of DCs in activating CD8 plus T cells, thus making them a very attractive target for vaccination against intracellular pathogens and diseases involving cellular immunity. With dendritic cells covered, let's check out some other immune cell types.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.